afternoon students, welcome to our Sheva group of school online class. Today we are going to see the lesson unit 6 sound. In the sound we are going to see the topic propagation of sound, sound waves, types of mechanical waves. These are the topic which we are going to learn about. Sound is product when an object is set to vibrate. Vibration means a kind of rapid to and for motion of a tractor. Sound vibration is a kind of rapid to and for motion of a particle. This is to and for motion of the particle cause the substance around it to vibrate. Thus sound spread to the surrounding. We all know that. So the substance through which sound is transmitted is called, that is, medium. When the substance which sound is transmitted is called medium. Sound moves through a medium from the point of generation to listener. We can understand the production of sound with the help of some activities. The activities, I am just explaining that on plugging the rubber band, it starts vibrating. We all see that in our childhood. You can hear a feeble humming sound as long as the rubber band is vibrating. The humming sound stops as soon as the rubber. So when the rubber band stops, the vibrating also stops. This confirms that the sound is produced by vibrating particle only. You can also see this kind of vibrations in stringing musical instruments like a guitar and sitar also. Propagation of sound. When you call your friend who is standing at a distance, your friend is able to hear your voice. Correct. How your friend is able to hear your voice? Because he is able to hear, because your sound travels from one place to another. That's why he replied to your question. So as we saw earlier, sound is a form of energy and it needs a medium to travel. This can be understood from the activity. Let's move to the sound waves. What is sound waves? Sound is a form of energy. You all know that sound is a form of energy. It is transferred through the air or any other medium in the form of mechanical waves. Mechanical waves is a disturbance which propagates in a medium due to the repeated periodic motion of the particles of the medium. Okay, I am just saying that which propagation that is in the medium due to repeated periodic motion of the particle of the medium. So from there, this meaning that is, there is a position. The disturbance which is caused by the vibration of the particle, it is passed over to the next particle. It means that the energy is transferred from one particle to the another. That is a wave motion. The characteristic of wave motion. What is the characteristic of wave motion? That is, first one is, in wave motion only the energy is transferred, not the particle. In that, the energy will be transferred but not the particle. Second one is, the velocity of the wave motion is different from the velocity of the vibrating particle. That is, that means the wave vibrating particle velocity is different from the wave motion of velocity. Okay, and then third one is, for the propagation of mechanical wave, the medium must possess the properties of inertia, elasticity, uniform density and minimum friction among the particles. So I am repeating the characteristics of wave motion because it is very important. So in wave motion only the energy is transferred, not the particles. And second one is the velocity of the wave motion is different from the velocity of the vibrating particle. And the third one is the propagation of mechanical wave. The medium must possess the property of inertia, elasticity and uniform density and medium fixation among the particle. Let's see the types of mechanical waves. What are the types of mechanical waves? There are two types of mechanical waves. One is transverse wave and another one is longitudinal waves. So there is a two types. One is transverse wave and another one is a longitudinal waves. Transverse waves. In a transverse waves, the particle of the medium vibrate in a direction which is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the waves. So the transverse wave of the particle of the medium vibrate in a direction only. Okay, then which perpendicular to the direction of the propagation of the waves. Example, wave in a string, light waves, etc. These are the example for the transverse waves. So transverse waves are produced only in the solid and liquid. Only in the form of solid and liquid. This is the transverse waves. Next one is a longitudinal waves. In a longitudinal waves, the particle of the medium vibrate in a direction. That is a longitudinal waves, which is parallel to the direction of the propagation. See the difference between the transverse and longitudinal. In transverse, I already told you. In longitudinal, it is parallel to the direction of propagation of the waves. Example, waves in spring, sound waves in a medium, and longitudinal waves are produced in solid, liquid and also a gases. But in the transverse wave, there is only solid. Okay, but in the longitudinal, there is a solid, liquid and gas also. Next is a musical instrument. So some sounds are pleasing to the ear and make us happy. The sound that provides a pleasing sensation to the ear, that is called as music. So music is produced by regular pattern of vibration. Musical instrument are categorized into four types of musical instruments. There are wind instrument, reed instrument, stringed instrument, percussion instrument. These are the four type of instrument. Okay students, in this lesson we know about the propagation of sound and sound waves, types of mechanical waves and also about the musical instrument. And let's move to the next lesson, that is unit 7. The magnetism. There is a topic, classification of magnets, magnetic field and the uses of magnet. Next one is the classification of magnets. What is classification of magnets? Magnets are classified into two types. How many types? Two types. They are natural magnets and artificial magnets. This is the natural magnets. Magnets are found in the nature or called natural magnets. They are permanent magnet. That is, they will never lose their magnetic power. These magnets are found in different place of the earth in the sandy deposits. So, limestone called magnetite, that is iron oxide, which is the ore of iron, is the strongest natural magnet. So this iron is the strongest natural magnet. Minerals like pyrrhotic iron sulfate, that means iron sulfide, and also these are the columbite or called natural magnets. Next one is a artificial magnets. Magnets that are made by people in the laboratory or factory are called artificial magnets. These are also known as man-made magnets, which are stronger than the natural magnets. Artificial magnets can be made in various shape and dimension. So, bar magnet, U-shaped magnets, horseshoe magnets, cylindrical magnets, disc magnets, ring magnets, and electromagnets are some example for the artificial magnets. So, artificial magnets are usually made up of iron, nickel, cobalt, steel, etc. Alloy of the metals neodymium and samarium are also used to make artificial magnet. Magnetic properties. The properties of a magnet can be explained under the following headlines, like attractive property, reflective property, and directive property. These are the magnetic properties. First one is a attractive property. The magnet always attract, that is a attractive property. So attract materials like iron, cobalt, and nickel. To understand the attractive property of a magnet, let us do some experiment, then only we can able to easily understand, because we all know that the north point will be attract in the south point only. It will not be attract to the north to north. That is not a attraction. It will be attract only from the south to north or north to south only. That is a attractive property. Next one is a repulsive property. The repulsive property means that is opposite to the attractive only. I already told you that the north pole will not be attracted by the north of the another magnet. It will be attracted in the opposite point only. So when the north meets the north, it will be repulsive property. And also when the south pole of the one magnet will not be attracted to the another south pole of the another magnet. So this is called as a repulsive magnet. Next one is a directive properties. What is directive properties? Directive properties means that it will be like a bar magnet which align itself in the geographic north-south direction. The property of the magnet by which it aligns itself along the geographic north-south direction when it is freely suspended. This is known as the directive properties. Next is a magnetic field. Just listen that the iron filling or arranging in the form of curved patterns around the magnet. The space around the bar magnet where the arrangement of iron filling exists represent the filling of influence of the bar magnet. This is called as a magnetic field. So magnetic field is defined as the space around a magnet in the which its magnetic effect or influence is observed. It is measured by the unit Tesla or Gauss, that is 1 Tesla is equal to 10,000 Gauss. Artificial magnet. Artificial magnets are produced from magnetic material. These are generally made by magnetizing iron or steel alloys electrically. These magnets are also produced by sticking a magnetic material with the magnetite or with other artificial magnets, depend on their ability to retain their magnetic properties. Artificial magnets are classified into permanent magnets and temporary magnets. Next, let's move to the uses of magnets. We come into contact with magnet often in our day-to-day life. So, they are used in wide range of devices. So, some of the uses of magnets are the ancient time, the magnets in the form of direction stone were used by seamen to find the direction during a voyage. Nowadays, magnets are used to generate electricity in dynamos. We also using the electromagnetic train also. So, electromagnetic are used in our day-to-day life. So, they are used in electric bells and electric motors. They are used in loudspeaker also and also in the microphone. An extremely powerful electromagnets is used in the fast moving molecules, trains and remaining floating above the tracks. So, in the industry, magnet conveyor belts are used to sort our magnetic substance from scrap mixed with non-magnetic substance. And magnets are used in computer in its storing device such as hard disk. Okay students, in this lesson we completed classification of magnets, magnetic field and uses of magnets. Okay students, I hope that you all are understand today video class. See you in the next class. Thank you.